What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose we are given a string along with a dictionary or a list of words. What we need to do is return true if that given string can be segmented into a space-separated sequence of one or more of the words in the dictionary. As an example, take this string and these words. Notice how the given string can be segmented into the following space-separated words, all of which can be found in the dictionary, hence the result is true. Furthermore, take this second example. Notice how here there is no way to segment this string using the given words, making the expected result of this operation false. Now, to solve this problem, the first trivial solution that may come to your mind is to transform this given list into a set, allowing for faster lookup, and then loop over the given string one prefix at a time. This will allow us to search every index for a word in the dictionary. As soon as a word is found, we reset our search starting from the index following that word and keep on going until we reach the end of the given string. This is a very viable solution and might work on several test cases, but not all of them. Why? Well, take this scenario as an example. You see here, if we make use of the logic we just covered, it will yield a false for us. However, we can clearly see that a true is expected, that indeed the words in the dictionary can fill up the given string. But why is this happening? Well, it's because we are only taking into consideration a single path and we are not considering intersections and prefixes among words inside the given dictionary. The previous dictionary we worked with did not have any prefix among the words stored inside it. However, this one does, and it's these prefixes that are preventing us from reaching the correct answer. To fix this, we will have to take into consideration every single possible scenario, meaning we must check every word, every time, and not stop after we find a word. The only conditions that should prevent us from further checking are if the string was completely traversed or if all possible existing scenarios were checked. The simple diagram we just did might remind you of something, and that something is recursion. You see, by making use of recursion, we will be able to execute the same piece of logic on several inputs and pick the output we want. Now, as we mentioned on several occasions, recursion is a top-down approach, meaning we must start with the whole string and then go back and apply the same logic on smaller parts of that string. So, we must loop over the list of words we have for each character in the given string. Then for each given word, we will check if that word exists in the given string starting from the back, meaning if it's equal to the suffix we are currently working with. If we find a match, we must loop over the words again to take into consideration every single possible path. This is done with the help of recursion by invoking the same method on the remaining part of the string. The result of the if condition we just wrote, if it passes, should simply be to return true as well. If we manage to reach the beginning of the given string, then we return true, as this means that a solution exists. Otherwise, we return false. Do not forget also to add a security check to make sure that the word we are working with does not exceed the remaining length of the string and throws an out-of-bounds exception. Okay, this solution works. However, we previously discussed the drawbacks of recursion and explained that dynamic programming is the optimal way to go when attempting to solve such problems. Let's go ahead and try to apply this technique and provide a more optimal code. As a start, and since we already have the recursive logic written down, let's transform it into the memoization approach, and to do this, we will have to create some sort of cache, an array or a map will do. This map will be passed down to the recursive method, which, as you can see, will still contain the same exact logic we previously wrote. The modification we need to do is that every time a solution is calculated, a boolean is stored inside this cache, allowing us to later retrieve it when the recursive method is called. To retrieve this value before any additional invocations are made, we simply add an if statement at the beginning of the recursive call that checks if the cache contains the current index we are dealing with. Another way to make use of dynamic programming is tabulation, also known as the bottom-up approach. The base logic behind it remains the same, but the implementation differs a bit as we will need to start from the bottom, which in this case is the beginning of the string. The main idea is to create a Boolean buffer array with the same size as the given string. That will keep track of all the possible word endings found in the string instead of doing that in the memory stack. This is implemented iteratively by replacing the recursive call with a for loop going over the indices of the given string. The inner for loop we had and the main conditions will remain the same, as you can see. However, this time, instead of returning with a Boolean or storing that Boolean inside a map, we will store the result inside the Boolean array we created at the beginning of the method. And after the method ends, the result we are looking for will be found in the last slot of that array. The last and main modification we must apply is instead of calling the recursive method in the inner if condition we were previously relying on, we need to check if the word we are currently working with when added to the string at hand will yield to a connected path. In other words, will yield to a true value inside the Boolean array, because if that is not the case, then there is no need to perform the equality check on the words and we should simply hop on to the next word in the dictionary. The link to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care and I will see you in the next one.